quarrel between Mr. Nair. This land was called Nairwadi. Now it is Hare Krishna land. So one day Guruji was here. We were sitting in this, you know, on 8th road.
Valia's house.
Huh? Valia's house. Guruji was there, myself, Valia and my wife was there in that room. So Valia said to Guruji that, "Guruji, Mr. Nair will not give you this land because he have offered by some hotel owner for 36 lakhs and you are purchasing for 14 lakhs and Mr. Nair has to pay so much income tax, so he must be change his idea and he will give the land to that person who is offered for 36 lakhs. Then Guruji said, "There is no matter. If he don't want to give this land to us, that he must return our money. But I don't think that he can pay the income tax in this life." So Guruji went at the night to Sydney. And when we awake up in the morning, we heard that Mr. Nair's heart failed and he died. So you can imagine that how Guruji said that I can't think that Mr. Nair will pay income tax burden in this life. So Mr. Nair finished.
তখন প্রসাদ রান্না করতে করতে অনেক দিন পর
I was cooking prasadam for Prabhupada every day. One day somehow the prasad was late. So Pallika cooked something quickly and took it to Prabhupada. Prabhupada asked, "Where is the prasad that Kishori cooked?" And he immediately asked the devotee to phone the big kitchen and find out why the prasad was late. So I hurried and quickly took the prasad to Prabhupada's house. When I got to the house, Prabhupada was standing in front of the stairs. I immediately put my head down and took the prasad inside. Just as I was leaving the house, Prabhupada asked me, "Why are you crying?" I said, "Prabhupada, because I delayed your prasad today." Prabhupada said, "I am not upset about that. What I am worried about is that if you delay my prasad, then you might one day delay Radha Madhav's prasad. And if you delay Radha Madhav's prasad, then he might become upset. That is why I have asked why my prasad was late."
He is always speaking truth, you see, and always quoting from Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and from Chaitanya Chaitanya, always quoting some slokas from those places. But he was so simple to answer those questions to us that anybody, even an atheist, will feel that I should be in touch always with Prabhupada.
Smile face, I am seeing him as a celestial flower of the paradise. Yeah, how affectionate man he is. I can't express the meaning of just such a smiling. I have never seen such a smiling.
Prabhupada used to go for a japa walk every morning with his disciples after Mangalarti. Some days he would walk to the math. Some days he would walk along the Ganges. Some days he would walk around the pukur. Some days he would come to the kitchen. After the japa walk, Prabhupada would come to Guru Puja, and as devotees would offer flowers to him, he would give them prasadam.
Once he said to me, "Dr. Kapoor,
forgive me for my offenses. I don't know what he really meant. I said, what do you mean? What offenses? That was his greatness, I think, his humility. You have done so much for Mahaprabhu, you see. What offenses? I can't understand what you mean. Humility, what else?
After Prabhupada would take darshan of Radha Madhava, he would go around the deities three times. Each time he would stop and ring the bell, and then he would raise his arms and dance. All the devotees would dance with him in ecstasy. When children would pass in front of him, he would stop again and dance. In this way, he would go around the deities three times.
I can only speak what I know from reading Prabhupada's books, because I never saw Prabhupada personally. I may not be able to do what Prabhupada did, but I know that in order to get free from this material existence, I should follow in his footsteps and follow the path that he has shown. In the future, I will try to dedicate my mind and life to Krishna, and of course, Prabhupada too.
He advised me in 1977, the 3-4 months before his disappearance, please take care of your mother and your family, because I left home, and you have two brothers, and your elder brother has become very inactive, so you must be well careful to take the responsibilities and all other things that may require for benefiting of your family and all other members.
You are telling me that I am going to build a in Vrindavan ashram, so I am going to build a special place for you to stay. I said, all right. When you go, I'll come.
But
last he went from there. I know, he sent me word.
Yes.
I'm going to Vrindavan now. And I don't think I'll come. He knew that he's going to go. I told him also, we'll get doctor. He said, no, good man. Very nice man. As a man also, he was very nice. Very kind, very soft, very nice. The man has done so much. And what did he take? Nothing. And he has left behind such a big landmark. Not only religion, culture, everything. All over the world. So we must try to see that whatever he has done is kept. We can't increase, all right, but we must keep it. It must remain alive. That is what I feel.
We are deeply charmed and rather we are very much proud of our father, that is your spiritual master, and of course he was also our spiritual guide. We are very much charmed and pleased that no ordinary people can do it. It is absolutely impossible for them, rather, to make a good mission and a big mission and wide range of propagation and all other, because it is very, we much feel rather very proud of our father, and this is our ultimate conclusion about that.